where were you on the night of 21st of June?
Well, I got my car to drive.
No, no, no. Start from the beginning.
I was eating my breakfast while reading a column on a recent prison break. I usually don't read the paper because of all the bad things that had happened. But this time, I couldn't keep my eyes off this story until Danny started going nuts about the dishwasher.
Damn it, the dishwasher's broken again!
That was the fourth time in 2 months that thing has broken on us.
I'll get it!
There's the phone again. It's been ringing for months now, non-stop.
Oh, hey, Kerry.
So, you had a male voice on the phone.
That's correct.
Hey, how are you? I've missed you.
I know, honey. I've missed you too. Just calling to check if you're still on for tonight.
Yeah, of course. What's the address of your new house?
76 Hill Street.
Great. Okay. I'll see you at 7.
Too easy. See you then.
Are you sure?
Positive.
Was this the first time you've heard this voice?
No, I said it's been ringing for months.
So you left the house without saying anything about the phone call?
Well, yeah. It's been going on for a while at this point. I just couldn't bring myself up to confront her.
So you went to work when you left?
Yes.
And you were a desk agent at Downtown PD?
Yes, my God. So many questions. Do you mind if I tell the story?
Go ahead, Paul.
So, there I am, in my little corner, doing the same thing every day, just shuffling papers. And my jerk of a boss walks up to me.
Paul! I want a flawless and precise report on Dennis Darko, done by Monday. Get this done well, we might be able to discuss you getting back out into the field. Get it done.
So this is Darko?
Yeah. Darko was charged for the murder of a 19-year-old girl.
And you're the arresting officer, I believe?
That I was.
Okay, keep going.
Hey honey, you still want to go out for coffee or lunch later?
Yeah, sure. What time?
Around 11.
Yeah, I can do that.
Okay, great. I'll see you then.
Sure thing. So, I then headed to meet her at the cafe.
So, how's your day been?
Garbage. What's new?
Well, I actually went to the dress shop today to return this dress I bought, and you would not believe how rude the customer service lady was. I had the receipt and I brought the dress. I hadn't even taken it out of the bag yet, and she said she couldn't refund me. Said it was something about policies. I wasn't really sure. I think she was making it all up. Are you even listening to me?
Yeah.
I'll stay your sugars here, ma'am.
Meeting in 15 minutes. I've got to go.
She must have thought I didn't notice, but to me it was clear as daylight.
So you let her go again without saying anything?
She's been sneaking around for months. I wasn't going to confront her in a cafe. Just wanted to talk later.
Okay, so she left the cafe and you just sat there?
No, I went back to work.
Is that you?
Who is this?
This is Michael.
She's not here right now.
So the voice you heard from the call on Danny's phone was the same voice you heard on the phone back home.
Yes, it was him.
Where'd you go? I
went to a couple of bars.
Do you drink when you're upset?
Who doesn't? I went to the house.
And you drove to the address you had over the phone.
Yes. I thought it was time I had to say something. I couldn't keep living like this, all these secrets and sneaking around. I got out of the car, went through the front door. It was open. The house was so quiet. I couldn't hear anything except for crying. Eventually I found her, dead on the floor, with someone crying over her. And all I can remember is being back in the car, reporting the incident.
You know what this is, Paul?
Yeah? That's my gun.
You were found holding two bullets in it. Daniel was found with three gunshot wounds to the body at the crime scene.
I don't understand.
Paul. We have reason to believe you killed Danny and Kerry.
Kerry? Who's Kerry? There was someone there, yes, but I couldn't tell who it was.
Kerry's the owner of the house, and the friend Danny went to see at 7. As she said so, the phone that morning, which you heard.
No, that wasn't her friend. It was the affair.
Danny, is that you?
Who is this?
This is Michael.
There was no affair, Paul.
There was. I'm sure of it. All the evidence proves it.
I know, honey. I've missed you too. Just calling to check we're still on for tonight.
I'll say your sugar's managed.
Paul. There is no affair. It's all in your head. It's always been in your head. This is all in your head.